We talked about the difference between accuracy and resolution, where accuracy is how close we can come to the measured value, where resolution is how finely can we actually measure it. If you look at the screen on the multimeter, we're reading 118.2 volts, so we can read this to a tenth of a volt. That would be the resolution. Now, the resolution is similar to what you would think of with an analog device, such as a tape measure. If you had a tape measure that could measure to a quarter of an inch, you would be able to measure something to a quarter of an inch, guesstimate to an eighth of an inch, you'd be hard-pressed to measure to a sixteenth of an inch. If this same ruler had sixteenth of an inch gradations in it, now we can measure to a sixteenth of an inch. So there, the resolution on one was a quarter of an inch, the resolution on the other was a sixteenth of an inch. With multimeters, we talk about digits and counts. So the digits that are in the display, the numbers you see on the display, the counts is how far it can count up. So here we have a meter that is a 2,000 count multimeter. It counts from 0 to 1999. This would be a 4,000 count multimeter. It counts from 0 to 4,000. And then we recently upgraded all our Fluke meters to be 6,000 counts, which actually benefits you quite a bit. So the resolution is really covered by the range. If I go to this multimeter, it auto-ranged into the proper range automatically. If I force it into its lowest range, in this case, which is the 6 millivolt range, we see OL on the display. Never take OL to mean that that's an open line. That means overload, there's more voltage on there than the range can measure. But if we look at where my decimal place went, we're now in the 600 millivolt range. My resolution goes all the way down to four places beyond the decimal place. If I hit the range again, I moved up to the 6-volt range. Now my resolution drops from four to three places besides the decimal point. If I move it up again, I'm in the 60-volt range. I still can't read 120 volts, but now my resolution is two places. When I get up into the 500-volt range, now my decimal point is here, and I can read 120 volts, and I could read it to a tenth of a volt. Why we went to 6,000 counts is with this meter, it would range up at 400 volts. You would not be able to see 480 volts with a tenth of a volt resolution. So by going to 6,000 counts, we've actually given you a little extra in your meter that you didn't expect. So to find the resolution on a meter, simply find the number of counts and start marching a decimal point through it, and you'll see what your resolution is on a particular range. Fluke 87 actually is two meters in one. One is your 6,000 count normal multimeter, and then by pressing the backlight button and holding it for a second, it shifts into a 20,000 count, where now you see we have an extra digit worth of resolution going to the right. So that's how we can determine the resolution of a multimeter and the difference between resolution and accuracy.